Okay, so again we will start our presentation. So you can see the Unix and Linux system administration handbook. This I shared on your screen. Okay, what is this now? This is the ebook, and this ebook, this book is already referred in your textbook, okay, reference book. So whatever the case studies. Okay, I'm talking about the case studies. Kindly listen me carefully. Whatever the case studies are given in the syllabus. Now you can observe that in unit number 2, there is a case study. Okay, so what I will do, I will share the syllabus with you. See here, now this is the syllabus. I shared the syllabus with you, and you can find there now in unit number 2. Okay, in unit number 2 there is a case study. Okay, what is the case study that is shown there? That is a case study, booting and shutdown scripting. Booting and shutdown is the one part, booting and shutdown, and then scripting and shell. Okay, that is the case study. So is this visible to everybody? The screen is visible. Whatever I share to you, that is visible to you. Yes. So still one more student is joining at 12:45, Sandesh More. Okay, it's here. So case study is given there in the unit number 2. You can see the booting and shutdown and scripting and shell. So what is this case study? Now, dear student, you can observe, if I scroll down in unit number 3 also, there is a case study, access control and rootly power and controlling processes. In unit number 4, there is a case study, open source automation, Red Hat Ansible. In unit number 5, there is a case study, container, Docker, container. And in unit number 6, there is a case study, advanced operating system like iPhone, iOS, Tizen, Iris, OS, Swift, and Virtual OS. Okay. So the case studies are given in every unit. Okay. We will focus on that case study here. Now, what is mean by case study? So after completion of your unit, okay, मेरी बात अच्छी तरह से सुनो. जब आपका unit खत्म हो जाता है, तब यूनिट में जो कुछ हमने पढ़ा है, वट एवर द थिंग्स वी लर्न एंड अंडरस्टैंड इन द यूनिट, ओके, उसको ज्यादा अच्छी तरह से समझने के लिए, मीन्स द एडवांस नॉलेज, इफ यू वांट अ मोर डिटेल एंड द एडवांस नॉलेज रिलेटेड टू दैट पॉइंट्स और आर्टिकल, वट एवर वी लर्न इन द यूनिट, टू गेट दैट एडवांस नॉलेज द केस स्टडीज आर गिवन. Okay, the case studies are given. Now, you can see, as in the unit number 2, there is a booting and shutdown, scripting and shell. So this case study is given. That means now some additional knowledge is given related to the booting and shutdown and scripting and shell. So you have to refer some literature for getting this advanced knowledge. Now this overview of this case study that I can give you, all faculty members can give you the overview of that case study, but it's a purely your responsibility to refer that literature and try to get some advanced knowledge. Try to clear your concept about the advanced knowledge that is given in that case study. So that whole things we cannot complete in the classroom or in the online session. A faculty member can give you the idea that how to approach, how to find out the information about that case study, and then you can increase, or you can, what you can say, you can improve your knowledge in that terms. So that is the case study. So केस स्टडी पढ़ने के बाद आपको उस टॉपिक के बारे में एडिशनल नॉलेज मिल जाएगा. So I can say that these case studies are the topics which are actually available in the industry, okay, and where the actual work is going on the industry related to that topic. ये सब कुछ जो कुछ मैं बता रहा हूँ केस स्टडी के बारे में, ये आपको समझ में आ रहा है क्या? आर यू गेटिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? इज दिस थिंग इज क्लियर टू एवरीबडी? व्हाट इज द केस स्टडी? तो मतलब आपको रिसोर्सेस मैं प्रोवाइड करूंगा, लिटरेचर मैं प्रोवाइड करूंगा, और आपको वो केस स्टडी लर्न करनी है. ओके अगर लर्निंग एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग करते समय कुछ आपको प्रॉब्लम आया तो ऑब्वियसली यू कैन अप्रोच टू मी एट एनी टाइम. वी कैन सॉल्व योर डाउट्स. ओके व्हाट एवर द क्लैरिफिकेशन यू रिक्वायर्ड रिलेटेड टू दैट केस स्टडी दैट वी कैन सॉल्व. बट इट्स प्योरली योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू लर्न एंड एग्जीक्यूट दैट केस स्टडी. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर टू एवरीबडी? और एनी प्रॉब्लम इज देयर? Kindly give the reply so that we can move forward. Yes. Okay. So still means somebody can have the problem. They can approach to me at any time. Okay. उनके सब डाउट सॉल्व करने की कोशिश मैं करूंगा. आपको जो कुछ प्रॉब्लम आ रहा है केस स्टडी के बारे में वो हम पर्सनली डिस्कस करेंगे. ओके यू कैन अप्रोच टू मी एट एनी टाइम व्हेन एवर योर ऑफलाइन सेशन बिगिंस. ओके इन कॉलेज और इवन यू कैन सेंड मी द मैसेज ऑन व्हाट्सएप रिलेटेड टू द केस स्टडी. वी कैन सॉल्व दैट. सो नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट सी what is the case study of unit number 2? So you can read in the syllabus. Case study is given putting and shutdown. स्क्रिप्टिंग एंड शेल. तो ये कहाँ से मिलेगा आपको? व्हाट इज मीन बाय दिस बूटिंग एंड शटडाउन? तो जो कुछ हमने ऊपर आर्टिकल में पढ़ा है कि इंट्रोडक्शन टू द कर्नल, फाइल सिस्टम, प्रोसेस कंट्रोल सब सिस्टम, डेटा स्ट्रक्चर टू द कर्नल. ओके मेनी थिंग्स वी लर्न इन द प्रीवियस टॉपिक. यू कैन सी द आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, इंट्रोडक्शन टू द सिस्टम कंसेप्ट, देन बफर कैचे, बफर हेडर, स्ट्रक्चर, बफर पूल, रीडिंग एंड राइटिंग ऑफ द डिस्क ब्लॉक. सो आफ्टर दिस नाउ अ बूटिंग एंड द शटडाउन इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोसेस. व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज एक्चुअली अ प्रोसेस. दिस बूटिंग एंड शटडाउन इज द एक्चुअल प्रोसेस व्हिच टुक प्लेस व्हेन एवर वी बूट द सिस्टम, एनी सिस्टम, नॉट ओनली द लिनक्स सिस्टम, एनी सिस्टम. सो दिस इज इक्वली एप्लीकेबल टू द विंडोज और एनी अदर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. वॉट हैपन वेन वी बूट द सिस्टम एंड वॉट हैपन वी शट डाउन द सिस्टम. सो दैट इज द थिंग बट बूटिंग एंड शट डाउन. नाउ यू कैन सी वन आर्टिकल इज गिवन देयर, बूट स्ट्रैपिंग. सो वॉट इज द बूट स्ट्रैपिंग? बूट स्ट्रैपिंग इज एक्चुअली अ प्रोसेस. ओके इट इज अ फिनोमेना वेयर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इज बूट. अगेन यू कैन आस्क द क्वेश्चन, सर व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम बूट? सो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम बूटिंग मीन्स अ सर्टन स्टेप्स आर एग्जीक्यूटेड राइट फ्रॉम वी पावर ऑन द कंप्यूटर, राइट फ्रॉम वी पावर ऑन द कंप्यूटर. देन व्हाट आर द सीक्वेंस ऑफ द स्टेप्स व्हिच आर एग्जीक्यूटेड इन साइड द कंप्यूटर? That is nothing but a booting. Normally, we call it as a booting the system. Okay. So that is a sequence of the steps. And finally, the kernel is loaded into the operating system. Finally, the kernel is loaded into the operating system. And that process is called as bootstrapping. Bootstrapping. Okay. So now, similarly, you can see the second article, the booting the PC. As I said, there are sequence of steps which took place when we power on the computer. That is called as booting the PC. Then the third article, there is, you can see the grub. Now, what is a grub? Now, grub is the boot loader. Okay, it's a very important point.
of this case study. GRUB, G-R-U-B. So what is the full form of this GRUB? This GRUB is Grand Unified Bootloader. Okay, what I said, this is a Grand Unified Bootloader. Let me type this thing in the chat box so that you can remember the full form of the GRUB. It is a Grand Unified Bootloader. So you can see in the chat box, I have written the full form of this GRUB. It is the one type of bootloader which is available in the operating systems. Okay. So this bootloader is there for your case study. So aapko padhna hai ki what is the bootloader? What is GRUB? What is Grand Unified Bootloader? And then you can see the third article, next article is booting with single user mode, then rebooting and shutdown. So this is the one part of your case study. Bootstrapping se lekar, booting, GRUB, booting with single user, and rebooting and shutdown is the part. Now, what I will do, I will, again, before that, you see the second part of the case study, there is written scripting and shell. Scripting and shell. So this is the second part of your case study. So aapko yahan pe matlab you can find there is case study mein aapko booting and shutdown ke bare mein padhna hai aur similarly scripting and shell ke bare mein bhi padhna hai. So what is the scripting? Shell scripting. I am talking about shell scripting. Okay, so in the sub article you can say you have to read a shell basics, then the bash scripting, and then there is a Python scripting and scripting based practices and working with startup scripts. So this is your case study. You can notice that already we are learning the shell scripting. Hum practical ke dauran shell script ke bare mein pad rahe. Okay, so that is the information whatever we learn in assignment number 1, assignment number 2, assignment number 3 and assignment number 4, that is related to the shell scripting. Okay, so uske bare mein bhi aapko case study hai. That already we are learning Python scripting ke bare mein. So that group B assignments are related to the C, C++ and Java and Python. There you will learn Python scripting. Lekin abhi group B ko jaane tak jaane ke liye humko bahut thoda time hai. So what you can do, you have to do some case studies. Execute this case study and start getting the advanced knowledge about these articles. So main aa raha hai na aapko abhi main aapko jo pehle maine बुक का पीडीएफ शेयर किया था, सेम बुक इज ऑल योर केस स्टडीज आर अवेलेबल इन दैट बुक. ओके, सो दैट आई विल शेयर. So you can notice the book title page is there. That is a Unix and Linux System Administration Handbook. Because your subject name is Operating System and Administration. एक चीज आपको मैं वापस याद दिलाता हूँ कि आपका टाइटल क्या है सब्जेक्ट का, ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. तो ये केस स्टडी के बारे में आप जो कुछ पढ़ेंगे, that all things comes under administration. और उसके लिए ये सेपरेट बुक है, बहुत अच्छी बुक है. इट्स अ वेरी नाइस बुक. ओके, ऑल थिंग्स आर गिवन हियर रिलेटेड टू द यूनिक्स एंड लिनक्स सिस्टम एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. लाइब्रेरी में भी ये कॉपी अवेलेबल है हमारे सेंट्रल लाइब्रेरी में. यू कैन रेफर द बुक देयर आल्सो, बट दोज हु आर नॉट गेटिंग देयर यू कैन रेफर द ई कॉपी. दिस कॉपी इज आल्सो अवेलेबल इन माय LMS अकाउंट ऑफ OSA. यू कैन गो एंड रेफर एंड डाउनलोड द सॉफ्ट कॉपी ऑफ दिस बुक, Unix and Linux System Administration Handbook. Now,
In this book, you can notice on the left hand side there is a chapter number 3 and chapter number 2. Okay, the mouse pointer, you can notice. You can notice the mouse pointer. So there is a chapter number 2 and 3. Okay, what is the chapter number 2? You can see the scripting and the shell. Okay, are you getting there? Scripting and the shell. You can see scripting and the shell. And chapter number 3 is booting and shutdown. So that is our case study. Chapter number 2 and chapter number 3, that is nothing but our case study. So जैसे कि आपके सिलेबस में बूटिंग एंड शटडाउन के बारे में पहले दिया है, तो आई विल क्लिक ऑन दैट. ओके, सो दिस इज योर केस स्टडी, बूटिंग एंड शटडाउन. ओके, सो एवरीथिंग इज अवेलेबल इन दिस चैप्टर रिलेटेड टू योर सिलेबस. व्हाट इज आई विल फॉर फ्यू मींस I will clear all these things to you. Case study के बारे में मैं आज आपको पूरा clear करूँगा, and then we will start our unit number 3. Okay, here. So what is this booting and shutdown? So you can read like most things in the Unix system, startup and shutdown have matured into carefully engineered process, and that accommodate many possible contingencies. The administrator, as the administrator, we negotiate the interests of the boot process to prevent and troubleshoot the problem. The effective system admin understand the fundamental first. Okay, so that is what I said earlier. So booting sequence and shutdown sequence, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर को अच्छी तरह से मालूम चाहिए. अ गुड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर, अ इफेक्टिव एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर अंडरस्टैंड द फंडामेंटल फर्स्ट. ओके, नाउ यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं बूटस्ट्रैपिंग. सो व्हाट इज अ बूटस्ट्रैपिंग? बूटस्ट्रैपिंग हैज ऑलवेज बीन समवॉट मिस्ट्रीशियस, बट इट वॉज सिंपलर इन द डेज वेन मैन्युफैक्चरर कंट्रोलर every aspect of the system's hardware and software. So things are given here, everything is available in this chapter, booting and shutdown. So I will scroll down. So bootstrapping, see the first article is the bootstrapping. Okay, bootstrapping. So what is the bootstrapping? The bootstrapping is a standard term for starting up computer. The operating system normal facilities are not available during the startup process. Just means for your understanding, I will read some of the points so that you can get some interest or information about this case study. So bootstrapping is the standard term for starting up computer. Operating system normal facilities are not available during the startup process. So computer must pull itself by its own bootstrap. Okay, see, normal facilities are not available during the boot process. So the computer can pull itself. Computer can pull itself by its own bootstrap. So during bootstrapping, the kernel is loaded into the memory and begin to execute. Okay, so whatever what is given here. During boot process, okay, or during bootstrapping, the kernel is loaded into memory and begin to execute. Okay, समझ में आ रहा है आपको? तो आपको पूछेंगे. Anybody can ask you that what is mean by bootstrapping. So bootstrapping की definition यहाँ पे दी है. So during the bootstrapping, the kernel is loaded into the memory and begins to execute. Next line you can read there. A variety of initialization tasks are performed and the system is then made available to the user. Okay, clear to everybody? अभी मैं पूरा चैप्टर यहाँ पे रीड नहीं करने वाला. आई विल नॉट रीड. मैं पर्पजली आपको ये सब कुछ दिखा रहा हूँ क्योंकि लेटर ऑन आप जब ये केस स्टडी के बारे में पढ़ने के स्टार्ट करेंगे तब आपको ये रिसोर्सेस मिलने चाहिए. ओके, जैसे मैंने शुरू में कहा कि टू increase or to improve your knowledge, to get some advanced knowledge about the concepts, the case studies are given. ये सोलली आपकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है, प्योरली आपकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि आपको ये केस स्टडीज को पढ़ना है. ये सब चीजें हम यहाँ पे कंप्लीट नहीं कर सकते, वी आर हैविंग सम लिमिटेशन. ओके, हमें सिलेबस खत्म करना है, हमें हमें सी आई ए जो है वो कंडक्ट करना है, हमें ट्यूटोरियल कंडक्ट करने हैं. ओके, तो ये प्योरली आपकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि आपका नॉलेज और इम्प्रूव होने के लिए आपको एक केस स्टडी अच्छी तरह से पढ़ना है. क्या पढ़ना है, कैसे पढ़ना है, ये सब चीजें हम आपको बताएंगे. पढ़ते समय आपको कुछ डाउट्स आया, कुछ प्रॉब्लम आया, तो हम यहाँ पे आपको डाउट्स और प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करेंगे. लेकिन आपको ये सब कुछ करना है. ओके, तो दैट इज द बूटस्ट्रैपिंग. सो बूटस्ट्रैपिंग, the kernel is loaded into the memory and begins to execute. Variety of initialization tasks are performed and the system is then available to the user. Okay, so that is the things are given here very nicely and effectively. You can see, I will scroll down. You can also read, the boot time is a period of special vulnerability. Okay, vulnerability means the rights, okay, the legal rights. Okay, so here what is given, see, the errors in the configuration, missing or unreliable equipment and damaged file system can prevent the computer from coming up. Okay, kabhi kabhi kya hota hai ki configuration mein error hai ya fir missing unreliable equipment, then file system damage hai. So because all these things, it all prevents the computer from coming up. Okay, all these things prevent the computer from coming up. So booting अच्छी तरह से होता नहीं, system boot नहीं होती है. क्यों नहीं होती है? क्योंकि file system damage होती है, क्योंकि unreliable equipment missing होता है. Okay, missing some equipments or some unreliable equipments are occurred. और configuration में error है, तो आपका computer अच्छी तरह से boot नहीं होता है. So boot configuration is often one of the first task of the system administrator. So you can see here I have highlighted this, and that gives you the importance that what is the booting, what is the importance. See, boot configuration is often one of the first tasks of the system administrator must perform on new system, especially when adding new hardware. Unfortunately, it is also one of the touchiest and it requires some familiarity with many other aspects of the system. Okay, it's a very important task and system administrators should go through this while booting the systems. Okay, now you can see the second subsection is given here, recovery, boot to the shell. Okay, then steps of the bootings are given here. You can see the steps in the booting process are given. So what are the steps, you can also read. The typical bootstrapping process consists of 6 distinct phases. So what are these phases? The first one is reading of the bootloader from master boot record, loading and initialization of the kernel, device detection and configuration. These 3 points are there. Okay, what is the first? Reading of the bootloader from the master boot record, loading and initialization of the kernel, device detection and configuration. Now I scroll down. Next one is creation of the kernel process, administrator interventions, that is single user mode only, and execution of the system startup scripts. So these are the 6 steps. Okay, what are the 6 steps? See here, 1, 2, 3, reading of the bootloader from the master boot record, loading and initialization of the kernel, device detection and configuration, creation of the kernel process, administrator intervention, that is single user mode only, and execution of the system startup scripts. So this is the 6 steps that
can complete in the bootstrapping. Okay. Now, here again, subsection it is given. What is kernel configuration? The kernel is a itself a program. We know that. We learned in the earlier article. Kernel is itself a program, and the first bootstrapping task is to get this program into memory so that it can execute it. So, pehla task kya hai? Ki kernel jo program hai, use memory mein load karna hai. That is nothing but a kernel initialization. Okay. So the path name of the kernel is vendor dependent. Abhi path name of the kernel is a vendor. Vendor ka matlab kya hai ki manufacturer. Jo operating system ya phir computer create karta hai, manufacture karta hai. That depends upon the manufacturer, vendor dependence. Okay. The path name of the kernel is vendor dependent, but it has traditionally been something like slash unique or slash VM unique. On Linux system, the kernel is usually some variation of slash boot slash VM Linux. Okay. So the sequence of this kernel is given, which is a program that needs to load into the memory, and then the booting can take place. So this is now here about 45 minutes are about to complete, and still students are joining. Like Gayatri Karanskar is waiting to join. Okay, I will admit her. Still the students are joining. I don't know why the students are joining late. Okay. This online is because certain issues are going on, like COVID-19 or this pandemic situation is going on. To avoid the this situation, the classes are conducting online and still students are joining too late. Okay. 45 minutes late. I don't know why students are not joining on time. Okay. It's your responsibility. Abhi, ये जो केस स्टडीज के बारे में मैं पूरा लेक्चर एक्सप्लेन कर रहा हूँ, दिस इज फॉर योर बेनिफिट ओनली, ओके, एंड स्टिल यू आर नॉट जॉइनिंग ऑन टाइम, ओके, नेक्स्ट टाइम यू सी यू ऑल शुड जॉइन बिफोर स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द प्रोग्राम, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द सेशन. आई ऑलरेडी स्टार्ट माय दिस गूगल मीट 10 मिनट्स बिफोर, 10 मिनट्स आई स्टार्ट माय सिस्टम, एंड You have to join on time. Okay. So here now this second point is kernel initialization is there, then hardware configuration is there. Okay, all things I will not read here. I will just show you that what are the articles available here. Kernel initialization, then hardware configuration. Okay, then next one is the creation of the kernel process. Okay, one basic initialization is to complete. The kernel creates several spontaneous process in the user space. They are called a spontaneous process because they are not created through normal system call like fork. Okay, see, they're very interesting. Main abhi aapko keh raha tha ki case studies are the advanced information. Aapko aapka knowledge thoda sa advanced improve karna hai, to aapko case study padhna padega. तो यहाँ पे क्या दिया है, देखो, कर्नल क्रिएशन ऑफ कर्नल प्रोसेस. सो सम स्पॉन्टेनियस प्रोसेस आर क्रिएटेड दैट आर नॉट क्रिएटेड बाय यूजिंग फोर्क सिस्टम कॉल. ओके, दैट यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न. एंड सम ऑफ द कॉमन कर्नल प्रोसेस आर गिवन हियर, लाइक के जर्नल डी, दैट इज कमिट द फाइल सिस्टम जर्नल अपडेट. देन के स्वैप डीप, that is swap process when physical memory is low, k soft irqd and k hubd. So this all k which is there at the beginning is nothing but the kernel and then the name of the process. So these are some common kernel process. So I will scroll down. So then execution of the startup scripts. Okay, then boot process completion. All these articles are given here. And then second point is booting the PC. So what happens when your system is actually, or your computer is actually booting? So that is given under this article. So then the grub. So see what is grub? Grub is a grand unified bootloader. Okay. So we will see something about this. So this is the program. This is again a program which is used to load the operating system. Okay. So bootloader hum keh rahe hai na, bootstrapping keh rahe hai ki कौन से बूटस्ट्रैपिंग कौन कौन से बूट लोडर मार्केट में अवेलेबल है. सो द वन इज द वेरी वाइडली यूज दैट इज द ग्रब. ओके ग्रब इज द वाइडली यूज बूटस्ट्रैप लोडर. ओके और बूट लोडर विच इज अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट विच इज द प्रोग्राम दैट कैन यूज्ड बाय मेनी ऑफ द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम टू लोड द कर्नल. ओके सो व्हाट इज गिवन हियर अ ग्रब विच इज डेवलप्ड बाय GNU project. Okay, so GNU, that is Genome Unix. Okay, which is actually a project which is developed for design and development of the Linux system. GNU, okay, Genome Unix. So a grub developed by this GNU project is the default bootloader for most of the Unix and Linux system with Intel processor. Okay, so this is the default bootloader available in most of the Unix and Linux system which is having a Intel process. Samajh mein aa raha hai aapko ki kya 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 importance hai bootloader ka, grub ka? Grub is available in most of the Unix and Linux system with Intel processor. Grub ships the most Linux distribution and with x86 based Solaris system version 10. Grub job is to choose the kernel from previously assembled list and load to the kernel with options specified by the administrator. The administrator ye grub ko modify kar sakta hai and according to its requirements the program can be modified. So kabhi kabhi kya hota hai ki hame windows bhi chahiye, dual boot kehte hai na hum, dual boot. So hame windows bhi chahiye, hame linux bhi chahiye, aapko linux mein fedora bhi chahiye, Ubuntu bhi chahiye. So whenever we want a multiple operating system, that time you can modify that grub. Clear to everybody? So that grub can be modified and then you can have a dual boot system. Okay, so that the administrator job. Now you can see all things are available here. A sample grub config file is given. This is a sample grub config file where you can see a title Red Hat. That means here only one operating system is available and from where the kernel process can taken. So just path name is given. Okay, the name of the operating system and the path name is given so that the operating system can boot from this path. Okay, now I will scroll down and you can see there are grub command line options. Now what are the grub command line options? Like reboot is there, find is there, root is there, kernel, help, boot, and all its meanings are given here. So this command you can use at the command line to perform various activities. Like reboot I can use to reboot the system, find I can use to find the files on mountable partitions, or root I can use to specify the root device, kernel load the kernel from the root device, help get the interactive help for the command. Then the kernel options are given here. Okay, I will scroll down and you can observe here one configuration file, the grub.config. okay, conf means configuration file. The grub.config file is shown for Windows XP and Red Hat Linux. देखो अभी यहाँ पे dual boot system के लिए grub का मेनू कैसा रहेगा. देखो title Windows and the title Red Hat. Red Hat is one of the Linux operating system. Like Ubuntu is there, Fedora is there, Red Hat is also there. Okay, so that thing is given here. One title is for Windows XP, another title is for Red Hat Linux, and if you want another one more, then you can modify there and you can have a third operating system also on your systems. That is called as multi booting, dual boot or multi booting.
This thing is clear to everybody? This thing is clear? Okay. So that is the point. Okay. Then see, the next point is booting to a single user mode. So how to boot to the single user mode? That is given here. Okay. And then working with startup script. Working with startup script. So some tasks are often performed in the startup scripts are setting the name of the computer, setting the time zone, checking the disk with FCK, mounting the system, removing the old files, configuring the network, and starting up the daemon and the network services. So working with startup scripts. Then a Red Hat startup script is given here. SUSE is another Linux operating system. Different startup scripts are given here. As I said that Ubuntu के लिए भी क्या startup script है ये भी दिए यहाँ पे Ubuntu startup scripts. Okay. So some advanced knowledge to improve your knowledge, you can then HP UX startup script is given. This can AIX startup script is given here. Okay. Booting Solaris. Then rebooting and shutdown. Okay, so booting, rebooting, and shutdown. So aap kya karte, three operations are there. First one is booting is the first operation. Rebooting, aap reboot bhi karte. Rebooting is the second operation, and shutdown is the third operation, last operation. So shutdown mein bhi kya hota hai? Ye sab kuch diya hai yahan pe. So that is there. So here it is ended. Okay, so booting and shutdown. Okay. So purposely today I explained to you what is the case study number one, that is the booting and shutdown. Okay, now you can see same book, the chapter number two is there, chapter number two. So I will click on the chapter number two. So this is the scripting and shell. So you can see, everybody can see scripting and shell. That is also the case study for you, scripting and shell. Okay, so that also two things are there for your case study. Okay, shell scripting and Python scripting. Shell scripting and Python. So I will scroll down. You can see. I mean, so जो कुछ आप ये shell program बनाते समय use करते हैं, that things are nothing but shell basic दिया है यहाँ पे. Shell basic, command line editing, then pipe and redirection, then sort options. बैश स्क्रिप्टिंग देखो अभी जो हम कर रहे हैं प्रैक्टिकल में, हाउ टू राइट अ प्रोग्राम, ओके, हाउ टू एग्जीक्यूट द प्रोग्राम, देन हाउ टू गिव द इनपुट एंड आउटपुट, हाउ टू यूज द इफ एल्स स्टेटमेंट, ओके, हाउ टू गिव द कमांड लाइन आर्गुमेंट एंड फंक्शंस, हियर फंक्शन इज यूज्ड हियर विद इफ एल्स. Then control flow, if else statement is explained here. And then you can see some elementary bash comparison operator like if statement mein humne kiya hai, x is equal to y. Okay, you can see how it is written. X is eq dash eq means x is equal to y. X dash ne means not equal to. Then this it means, you can see it means less than y. So all things are here, okay, related to the shell script jo hum already practical mein pad rahe. Loop, control loops are there, like for loop is here, for condition, do, done, फॉर और व्हाइल के लिए सेम, लगभग सेम स्ट्रक्चर है. ओके, देन व्हाइल इज देयर, व्हाइल कंडीशन डू डन, जो ऑलरेडी हम प्रैक्टिकल में पढ़ रहे हैं. ओके, नाउ यू फैमिलियर विद दिस बैश स्क्रिप्टिंग. एरे कैसे यूज करना है ये इसके बारे में दिया है, एरे एंड अर्थमेटिक. ओके, सो यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज द एरे इन द शेल स्क्रिप्ट. Then how to use the regular expression in the shell script? Okay. This Perl is not there for your case study. Perl programming is not there for your case study. So I will scroll down and one more scripting is there for your case study that I will show you. Python scripting, yes, this Python scripting is there for your case study. Okay, so 2.5. So how to write a Python program, how to execute the Python program, ये भी हम second group में, group B में पढ़ने वाले हैं. जैसे हम group A में shell scripting पढ़ रहे हैं, तो group B में हम Python भी पढ़ने वाले हैं. लेकिन अभी this is a good chance to everybody, this is a good time and good chance to everybody that case study अगर आपने start किया पढ़ने के लिए Python के scripting के बारे में, तो already many doubts will be clear and that help you to execute the program of your group B assignments. So you can see how to Python quick start, how to write the program in Python, how to execute again, what is object, what is string, number, list, dictionaries, tuple, files, this thing is given there. Okay. Python input loops, how to use the loops in Python, how to, and then the scripting best practices. What are the best practices for using the scripting? That is given in this article. Okay, the small article is there. And then, yes, it is finished. So that is there related to the scripting and shell. So dear student, this thing is clear to everybody that whatever we learn in this online session, today's online session, I explained to you about your case study of unit number 2, that is scripting and shell and booting and shutdown. Okay, so you refer this book, Unix and Linux System Administration Handbook, okay, for getting advanced knowledge about this case study. So I will now take the attendance, okay, and then after you can leave the meeting. First of all, I will call the roll number, don't leave. Okay, attendance is very important. Okay, so I will call the roll number, just a minute. It is 23. Okay. And now I will call the roll number and you just unmute yourself and give that attendance. Roll number 82 there. 82.
Present, sir.
83.
Present, sir.
84.
Present, sir.
85. 86.
Present, sir.
87.
Present, sir.
88. 89. 90.
Present, sir.
91.
Present, sir.
Those who have given the attendance, they can leave the meeting. जिसने attendance दिया है वो meeting leave कर सकता है. Then roll number 92.
Present, sir.
93.
Present, sir.
94. 95.
Present, sir.
96.
Present, sir.
97. 98, 99,
present
100,
sir.
101,
present sir.
102,
present.
103,
present.
104, 105,
present.
106, 107, 108,
present sir.
109,
present.
110, 110, 10, 11,
present sir.
12,
present.
13, 14,
present sir.
15,
present sir.
16, 17, 18,
present sir.
19,
present sir.
20,
present sir.
21,
present.
22, 23,
present.
24,
present.
25, 26, 27, 28,
present.
29,
present sir.
30,
present sir.
31,
present sir.
32,
present sir.
33,
present sir.
34,
present sir.
35, 36, 37, 38, 39,
present.
40, 41, 42, 43,
present.
44, 45,
present.
46,
present sir.
47, 48,
present sir.
49, 50, 51, 52,
present sir.
53, 54, 55, 56,
present.
57, 58, 62, 63, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84.
Sir, direct second year, not available.
Sir, 154.
Sir, 113.
Just a minute, one by one. 154. 154. Dhanashri Kote. Yes, next.
Sir, 113.
113. Just a minute. 113. Jappe Sanket.
Yes, sir.
Next. 89. Sakshi Khatale.
89.
Yes. Next. Anybody remain to give attendance? Okay. Sab logon ne diya hai. Yes. Krishna Prathamesh. Thank you very much.